And you have to take a vow saying that fire is a witness and I cannot really lie because fire is ultimate truth and the ultimate supreme power. And once the person takes that home after marriage, they used to carry the fire home. And that fire used to be the origin of every fire that would be lit within the family, within the house. Okay? And that was 24 hours, eternal fire. It never could be extinguished. And a lot of people in India today have that. And we are initiating on Rashan that fire from the next month, from the month of January. The fire which will never get extinguished. Fire which will be kept burning all the time till the eternal time. Unfortunately, during the last many, many years, I think our lifestyle has changed. The human value change and the activities change. You know, the whole process of life is so different in the last few years, few hundreds of years rather. The Agnihotra was lost, the idea of Agnihotra was lost. It remained as a ritual. But there's a lot of ritualistic people started feeling, oh, it is only a ritual, and they lost the science behind. Which happens with most of the civilizations and most of the sciences. What is today's science probably would lose that essence of science over a period of time. Because every science is made up of three parts, the principles of science, the process of technology of the science, and the application of the science. Over a period of time, what happens is the principles are not really required because they don't matter. The processes are also lost, and what remains is only the application, which is called rituals. Same thing happened to Agnihotra. You know, and what is happening today, if you see mobile technology, I wonder whether how many people really using the mobile really know what technology is used for them. How many people really know the principles of television when they're watching the television? Because every science ultimately gets into the zone of application and gets stuck there. Same thing happened to Agnihotra. Fortunately, in the 1940s, about 1942, India had a great saint called Gajanan Maharaj, the tradition from which I come. And he was the first one to get an insight about the Agnihotra. And he was initiated by the supermaster, Lord Parshurama. He is considered to be reincarnation of the Lord Vishnu, the Lord of administration or maintenance. We have Trinity. We talk of creation, maintenance, and the destruction. Now, Lord Vishnu is supposed to be the deity. I mean, this one of the Trinity is to look after the governance of the whole universe. And that reincarnation, Bhagavan Parshurama actually gave this beautiful knowledge to Gajanan Maharaj. In 1942 onwards, he started working it and devoting his whole life for this purpose. And over a period of time, around 1972, it took about 30 years to envelop, he had one disciple called Sri Vasant, who was very well known, and he has done a lot of work. He was the first one to initiate Agnihotra in the way it is today. And they made a whole package of Agnihotra as a method that we can apply every day, considering our current lifestyles. So this is a small process, which is about 5 minutes in the morning at sunrise time, and 5 minutes at the time of sunset. Can I have the Agnihotra part, pyramid? I'll show you what it is. It's basically, it's a very, very simple process, one of the most simplest process in the world to do, and one of the most effective results one can get. So if you look at the rewards to investment in terms of time, in terms of money, in terms of resources is very, very less. In fact, when we talk about a lot of people ask me about how much does it cost to every day to work, and it works in probably 10 pennies, right? You talk about it? 10 pennies a time. And what it gives, probably it gives you your whole life, whole happiness, health. Now this is a small part, okay, and this is made of copper. Now this is called pyramid. And there's a reason why it is called pyramid. Pyramid means fire plus amid. Fire is the fire. Amid is the center. Any structure on the center of which is the fire is called pyramid. So this is as simple as that. This is a specific pre-requisition size, you know, pre-designed sizes of 5.75 inches length, 5.75 inches breadth, and 5.25 inches height. Okay, this is how it is made. Any deviations are not allowed, because ultimately if we are going to look at the science and technology, I think we better respect this wisdom, okay? Now this could be either, ideally they say in Vedas, because Vedas were the old times, you know, when probably the gold was not gold as we know today. They say you could use gold because it gives the maximum result. But I'm sure that we can discount today use of gold for this purpose. The copper is the next option. This is copper. And a lot of poor countries and a lot of poor people who cannot even afford copper should use earthen pots. they equally work well and they offer the same effectiveness. This is a stand in which normally it is kept, and we have your pointer. Now, why the pointer is required? It has no other purpose, but if I keep it in the east, I have always got to keep this in the east. That is just to indicate that I'm not changing the direction of my Agnihotra. If I keep it on the west, let us say on this side, I'll always keep it in this way. Agnihotra is always performed in the east-west direction, the movement of the sun. Okay? Now, this is as far as the container is concerned. The second thing, what are the ingredients of this? What do we do? We have the cow dung. Yeah. The cow dung is a major ingredient as far as the generation of energy is concerned. This is used as a burning fuel. This is a dried cow dung, and it comes in a beautiful quality. It burns very fast, and it is very medicinal in value. This is one of the things, you know, which everybody discards. So